What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to the channel. Today you'll be watching some search and destroy gameplay. Here I'm using the ISO, a not new weapon, but you know, probably new to most of you guys. Most of you guys probably only see the Uzi, the MP7, the Val, things like that, especially when people play mono for search. But I want to spice it up. Let's use an ISO and actually do decent. I get like 19 kills in this. I don't know if you'll see all of it, depends on how long this commentary is. The gameplay is unrelated to the commentary, because today I want to talk about Cold War and I guess what it's doing wrong, and more so what Call of Duty is doing wrong. In my opinion, Call of Duty is just messing up in terms of finances. I think that they made a good move back in Modern Warfare when, you know, they made the Battle Pass free, they made weapons free, like DLC content free, because, you know, prior to that, Black Ops 3, Black Ops 4, terrible, like awful microtransaction systems that nobody was a fan of, all right? Like, just ask around, nobody was a fan of those systems. So I'm glad that Modern Warfare and obviously now subsequently Cold War is doing it right. And when I say doing it right, I mean like, the, for instance, the PPSH, like DLC weapons are free for pretty much everyone as long as you play the game enough, right? That's what I mean by not free, that's what I mean by doing it correctly. And I think that's how it should be done. I think COD would have been very successful, if not more successful, back then if it had been like this from, I guess, the beginning of time. But, you know, anyway, regardless of all that, what inspired this commentary in particular is actually the John McClane, John Rambo, like, skins from the Cold War store. Because, you know, I was looking through it, you know, when I first saw the trailer like for, like, Cold War Season 3 Reloaded or whatever, I was like, oh, that's kind of cool. Like, maybe if it's a decent price, I'll consider it or something like that. And you know what happened? They are $25 a piece. Like, I know this is not news anymore at this point, you know, I'm sure you guys like have heard of this or probably know this by now, but dude, $25 for an operator skin, one, right? You don't even get two, as Blame Truth has mentioned in his videos. The fact that you only get one and then some like blueprints stuff and stuff like that, like all that other extra stuff is just stuff to like pad it, you know? It's kind of like when you, I don't know, I don't even know, have an explanation or whatever, but it's not real stuff, all right? It's not stuff that you actually care about. It's not stuff that you actually want. You know, it's like calling cards or stickers or like even blueprints, weapon blueprints for guns you already have. It doesn't matter that much, you know? You could do without it. My big gripe about their store right now, besides the fact that they make sure that their store never, you know, messes up or anything, you know, sometimes the game, maybe the lobbies will kick you out of games, but the store, no, we never kick you out of the store. If you're in the store, we got to make sure you have a pleasant experience. We got to make sure you do whatever you can to buy something, or we do whatever we can to help you buy something. You know, they're very just, oh, the store comes first. But yeah, my biggest gripe for the store, I guess in general, is the fact that those prices are so high in a paid game, right? We already paid 60 bones for this game. And then on top of that, there's no feature, there's no ability to unlock these cooler things for free. There's no ability. So for instance, you know how the PPSH, you can unlock that for free, you know, but you can also buy a bundle to get it right away if you don't want to. Or like the Carve 2, for instance, like a new tac rifle mid-season, something like that. You can do a challenge to unlock it, or you can simply, what's it called? You can simply purchase a bundle, right? And I think what they're going for there is they don't want people to feel like they have to spend money on weapons, which is fine. It's fair, right? I don't want to feel like I have to spend money on that either. But when it comes down to it, there's nothing in the store, in my opinion, that is fairly priced that's worth it. Whether that be the Rambo skin, the John McClane skin, some Tracer packs, you know, like these are the things that I think are worth it in Call of Duty. You know, whether you think so or not, it's up to you. But me personally, I think those are the things that are worth it in COD. And my gripe about the store is that there's no like free feature to get them. There's no, you know, win 200 games or get 1,000 kills with a submachine gun or something like that. You know, even if it's like a weekly or monthly challenge, it takes super long, you know, and you know, you have to be crazy to do it. Give me the option to do it. I want the option to be quote unquote that crazy in order to unlock that thing for free, because I want to, you know, play this game. I think it just makes like logical sense. If you, you know, give this huge challenge, just like a stupidly annoying challenge, say it's like win, I don't know, 15,000 matches, like, do you know how long that's going to take just to get like I don't know, your choice of a free item in the store or something like that? Give me that option. It'll keep me, maybe not like I'm not going to wake up every day grinding for that, but you know, it'll get me to play this game more because I'll have that in the back of my mind. Oh, should I get off of Cold War and play Rocket League or Apex Legends? Oh, I probably shouldn't, because I should probably just keep grinding for the store win or something, for the store bundle. You know, give me that option. And it just makes logical sense because it will give, or it will increase the player time, the play time in this game. And that's what they want, right? That's what they want to show their shareholders. I don't know what's the point of not doing something this simple and so rudimentary. I think a couple days back I mentioned in when I was talking about Black Ops 4, how infinitely more replayable that game got when they added the reserve systems, to where you could trade in, 50 crates for a weapon of your choice, a Mastercraft weapon of your choice. And that's just genius, because it keeps you logging on every day with the daily contracts, daily rewards, which keeps the player base high. And then, the reserve crates, they're not cheap, but they're not super expensive either. 50 crates, I mean, you can get some bundles in your daily challenges. You can do all sorts of stuff, right? It's not impossible. I guess that's what I'm saying. It's time consuming, but that's what a challenge should be, okay? A challenge shouldn't be, I wake up, get 5 kills, and that's my free weapon. Like, it shouldn't be that easy. I'm not saying it should be super difficult either. I definitely don't want to do super difficult or super annoying challenges. Like, don't make me mount, don't make me go for long shots or something. Like, oh my god, don't give me any challenges that make me have to change up the way I play the game, the way I play Call of Duty, okay? Nobody wants that. Nobody's gonna have any fun, if you force everyone to sit in the back with a sniper or get a hipfire kill with a sniper. Like, no, nobody's gonna have fun playing like that. This is just something I've been thinking about here and there, because mostly because of Blame Shoot's video where you talked about the John McClane, John Rambo bundles. And what's sad about Call of Duty is that these are cool additions, but I'll never experience them. I'm not paying extra for this game that I probably am not going to play that much. And even if I did, even if I wanted to, right, and I wanted to, support the game or whatever, I can't see these operators. It's not a bundle for me. It's like a bundle gift for my teammates and the enemy team I'm playing. They get to see their stuff. Tracer packs, on the other hand, is something that I actually find kind of cool. It's a unique, cool idea. I don't think I've seen it in other shooters. Maybe it's there, maybe I just live under a rock or something, but the fact that, tracer packs aren't like, I guess, like, unlockable. I think there was one for the AS Val in like a battle pass or something like that. That's a cool idea. Give me more of that, right? If you're willing to give it once, why would you not be willing to do that more in the future? I don't understand. In my personal opinion, Activision, Call of Duty, they only benefit from taking my idea of, making unlockable challenges for certain store items. I know they do it for weapons already. I'm not disputing that. And it's, I'm happy with that. But I want them to do some kind of challenge, no matter how tedious. I know, in a few months, if they do this and they make it so it's like win, 5,000 matches to unlock like one gun or something like that, I know people are going to be like, oh my God, this is so annoying and stuff like that. And I know I'm probably going to complain about it too, because it's a little outrageous. But at the bare minimum, they listened to this commentary, or at least thought about it, and at least they're trying to up their playtime, right? I think COD, especially multiplayer 6v6, it's in a dangerous state of just not surviving, with the strength of Warzone and how pretty much everyone is just buying stuff for Warzone. I don't know if COD 6v6 is going to survive. I've made countless videos on that in the past as well, so go check those out if you haven't already. But yeah, man, that's something I've been thinking about, let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Don't want to drag this on too much longer, but I just thought that it made sense in my head. I want to vocalize it. Let me know what you guys think about in that comment section down below. And thanks for watching. Leave a like, subscribe if you're new to the channel. Really appreciate that. Links to my Twitter, Twitch, and Discord are in the description down below as well. Hope you enjoyed the gameplay, and have a great rest of the day, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.